Congress joining us now to share his thoughts on President Biden's first 100 days as RNC spokesman, Paris Denard. Paris, welcome back to the National Desk.
Thanks for having me. Glad to be with you.
So this is the president's first speech to a joint session of Congress. What are you looking for the president to discuss tonight as he does mark his first 100 days?
You know, I'm really interested to see which Joe Biden shows up. It'll be the Joe Biden from the campaign trail who said he was going to be more of a moderate and said he was, you know, not going to be for ending fracking, raising taxes. I don't know which Joe Biden's going to show up. It's going to be the Joe Biden that we've seen governing as president, who has actually said he supports court packing and raising taxes and closing the things that we need in terms of jobs with the Keystone Pipeline. I don't know which Joe Biden's going to show up. Will it be the Joe Biden from the campaign trail who said he was going to be a unifier and be bipartisan? Or will it be the Joe Biden who has led as president, who has been actually a failed leader, I would say, in terms of really being divisive on issues of race, divisive on issues of the economy, divisive on things that where we needed him to be a uniter and be bipartisan? He hasn't been that way. So I'll be interested to see which Joe Biden shows up.
Well, a major issue he's dealing with is the crisis at the border, as we all know. So yeah. What should the president focus on, do you think, when it comes to ensuring Americans that he is working to control what's happening right now at the border?
I think Joe Biden has to convince the American people that he is working to do just that. Because since he's put his vice president in charge of the border, she is not. Vice President Harris has not held one press conference. Vice President Harris has not gone to the border. She's gone to California. She's gone going to all these other different states, New Hampshire and everywhere else, but the border. She hasn't met with Border Patrol. She hasn't talked to business owners and ranchers and people that are on the ground there that have been impacted by this. She hasn't seen the facilities that where children are literally sleeping on top of each other. And your report earlier just said they're at capacity and they're still coming over. The border is wide open. It is a national security issue. It is a health issue. It is a big, big, big problem that is a crisis. So the first thing they have to do is acknowledge the crisis and then show how they're fixing it. Vice President Harris said she's not even responsible for it when he put her in charge of it, and she's not even going down to meet with the people that are on the border to deal with it. She's having these Zoom meetings with everyone else except for the people that are really impacted on the border. This is a crisis, and they're not dealing with it.
One thing that we know he is going to talk about that we got word of last night was universal pre-K, as well as free community college. All of this comes with a massive price tag, as we know. And part of Biden's tax plan, and one that's gotten a lot of attention lately, is doubling capital gains taxes. The largest increase in 65 years is what he's suggesting. Now, economists will say this is not a party issue and would be disastrous because of inflation and market efficiency. They think it's going to be counterproductive by short-circuiting market activity. What's your thoughts? How will this affect the average middle-class family in the long run?
I think the economists are right. This is not a partisan issue. This is not a Democrat or Republican issue. It's a green issue, meaning it's about the economy. It's about your pocketbook. It's about your money. And at a time of economic troubles that we're seeing because of the COVID-19 virus and because of this global pandemic, the last thing that American families need are tax hikes or tax increases or increasing the taxes on our corporations, making them less competitive globally so that they're going to be paying a higher tax rate. And you know what? At the end of the day, it's all going to come down to the American people. They're going to pass on. If others get taxed high at a higher rate, it's going to come down to the consumer. We're all going to get hit. And it's not just the tax increases on capital gains and other things like that. It's going to be the increases when it comes to gas prices and energy prices. It's going to be the fact that parents are still not able to fully go to work because schools are still closed. And our economies are not open. So it's a holistic approach of raising taxes and having bad policies that are really going to impact the American families. So when he talks about an American family plan, this is not some cell phone plan. This is a real plan that's going to impact people. At $1.8 trillion on top of the $2 trillion he's already putting, who's going to pay for it? The American people.
South Carolina Senator Tim Scott, we know, is giving the Republican response to the president's address. I'm sure you've talked to him. What should we expect to hear from Senator Scott tonight?
Senator Tim Scott is one of the most inspirational leaders we have in the Republican Party. And I think tonight he's going to highlight the contrast of visions, the conservative free enterprise opportunity focused vision that's going to be uplifting and empowering for the American people, juxtaposed to that of Joe Biden's disastrous first 100 days. And he's going to highlight the difference between what free enterprise, free thinking, conservative policies can do to empower Americans, to uplift Americans. And he's going to highlight the vision forward and show people and remind the American people of the accomplishments that were made by the former president, President Trump, and the congressional Republicans that led to opportunity zones, that led to taxes being cut, that led to job creation and low unemployment and safety and security and a closed border that left us more safe. He's going to highlight that. It's going to be a very inspirational speech. I'm looking forward to it.
All right, Paris. Great talking to you with you this morning. Thanks for joining us here on the National Desk. Have a good one.
Thanks for having me.